Operator services are currently suspended, pending automation. The Echo River Central Exchange is being phased out and replaced with the new consolidated auxiliary switch number 30. This is a recording. You may hang up at any time or stay on the line for more information. Service surcharges formerly negotiated by Loretta will now be reflected on your electric bill. If you are having difficulty remembering the number you wish to dial, check your pockets for a scrap of paper. You may have written it down. The long-distance fee structure has been reconfigured as of September. When referring to the August fee matrix, please make the following adjustments. Zone 7 is now combined with Zone 3. There is no longer a Zone 7.
A public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. For a menu of our resources, press 1. If you have an extension to dial, press 9. For more information about our organization, press 3. If you don't remember dialing this number at all, press 5. To hear these options again, press 0. So, you don't remember dialing this number. You just sort of woke up with the phone pressed to your ear, ringing on the other end. Or maybe you thought you dialed a different number, but your digits betrayed you. Or there's a faulty connection somewhere out there in that spiderweb lattice of phone cords that covers all of creation. It must be kind of a nice feeling, really. It's like you and I just bumped into each other in the street or a little cafe. Say, next time you meet a stranger, call us back at extension 7864 and hand them the phone. We'd love to get to know them. Welcome home. For historical sites along the Echo River, press 1. For a guide to the river's flora and fauna, press 2. For help identifying an unfamiliar sound, press 3. If you're holding a snake right now, press 4. To hear So, you're probably not in any danger, but why are you holding that snake? If you're involved in an exchange of some kind, press 1. If holding the snake is part of your spiritual practice, press 2. If you don't remember why you're holding the snake, press 3. To return to the main menu, press 0. Okay. What's the last thing you remember? Please describe your memory in as much detail as you are able, paying particular attention to any smells and sounds you may recall. Were you breathing through your mouth or your nose? What did the air taste like? And so on. Feel free to call again with extension 1618 and tell us the whole story. All right, let's roll up our sleeves and get to work on this here snake situation. What you're going for is a kind of gestural conversation. Don't worry. I'll lead you two through it. Give that snake a name and look her right in the eyes and say her name. I'm going to go with Delia for the purpose of demonstration, but you pick a suitable name. Try to follow along with me here to the best of your ability. Delia, take it easy now. What if all of this is just a reflection of a reflection? Now hold the silence while she processes that metaphysical curveball. Okay, what's Delia up to now? If she's staring right back at you, press 1. If she's wriggling around, press 2. And if she's just kind of limp, press 3. Well, good, now you got her attention. Now, leading with your shoulder, slowly tilt your body to the left, always maintaining eye contact. Adjust your feet as necessary. You want to do a full rotation over several seconds. It's normal to feel a bit self-conscious. Try not to get tangled up in the phone cord, or next time, plan ahead and use a cordless. All right, where are we at? If the snake is breathing heavily, press 1. If she's curled around your forearm, press 2. If her tongue is extended, press 3. You just point your tongue right back at her. If hers moves left, yours moves right, and so on. Maintain eye contact so she knows you're not making fun of her. There you go. Delia should be in a kind of a calm, thoughtful state now, so you can move on. So, put that snake in some grass or something. Let Delia be free, like a snake should. And go ahead and wash your hands if you care to. I would. Welcome home. For historical sites along the Echo River, press 1. For a guide to the river's flora and fauna, press 2. For historical sites along the Echo River, press 1. Well, if you're dialed into this here informational resource, then you're a certain kind of beachcombing, bat-calling sightseer. So let's take a driftwood inventory. For a diver's guide to underwater islands, press 1. For forgotten places, press 2. For restless places, press 3. For what little we know of the iron pariah, press 4. For food and drink recommendations, press 5. To return to the main menu, press 6. The iron pariah is just what she's called along the Echo River. Of course, she once had another name, but it's been scratched away, maybe out of shame? Or maybe she took a bend too sharply and left her true name on a rock. So, what else? We know she was in the war, but neither side would claim her. We don't know if anyone's aboard. She drifts along the water and commands a wide berth. Tourists, if you hope to document the Iron Pariah, I fear you will be disappointed. She has a beguiling way of vanishing from photographs. Steer to shore and let her be carried along in silence. Pilgrims, I wouldn't dare to interfere. For a diver's guide to underwater islands, press 1. Perhaps it's the violent displacement of natural gases. Perhaps the river tilts to face the moon, slowly changing the angle of its surface over time. Some sailors blame corked rocks. Whatever the geological explanation, the islands of the Echo River are mostly transient, rising and diving on some inscrutable schedule. The following islands are presently underwater. The Blue Island. Island of Eusapia. Baucis Keys. Dog Shit Island. Loose Tooth Rock. Chorus Keys. This list is current as of now. For a diver's guide to underwater. For secret tourism, forgotten places are the vital spark. Take no pictures here, nor souvenirs. Write no travelogues. We will discuss these places now in vague and qualified descriptions. For the town with no roads to it, press 1. For the silo of late reflections, press 2. For the monument to something that we don't remember what it is, press 3. There is a town which has its own roads, but which no other roads connect to. They send and receive mail. There is a school, and so on. But what I want to tell you about now is the horses. There are horses living wild in this town. I forget how they got there. They don't stay in stalls. They sleep outside. They walk through the town, on the streets or on the sidewalks, and the people of the town think of them as elegant, wordless neighbors. For a diver's guide to underwater islands. For secret tourism, forgotten places are the vital spark. Take no pictures here, nor souvenirs. Write no travelogues. We will discuss these places now in vague and qualified descriptions. For the town, there is a silo so tall and strange that it can take years for an echoing word to bounce from bottom to top and then bottom again. If you wait patiently, you may overhear the conversations of earlier visitors. I once had an argument there with a dear friend, but I forget what it was about, and we haven't spoken since. Maybe I'll go find out someday. For a diver's guide to underwater for secret tourism, forgotten places are the vital spark. Take no pictures here, nor souvenirs. Write no travelogues. We will discuss these places now in vague and qualified descriptions. For the I suppose it must have been an important event if we felt we needed to commemorate it. The monument looks like it was a lot of work to put together. I wonder if it was a happy occasion, something we were celebrating and didn't want to let go of, or if instead it was something so horrible that we never wanted to forget it, for fear that we'd accidentally do it again. There isn't a plaque or anything. I guess we didn't think we'd need one. For a diver's guide to underwater islands, press 1. For forgotten places, press 2. For restless places, press 3. For what? For the cluttered place, press 1. For the flooding place, press 2. For a list of the places where people can't sleep, press 3. There is a place always cluttered by debris floating along the water. Otherwise, it's unremarkable. In fact, the only way to find it is to notice that there happens to be more trash there than anywhere else around. I wonder why that is. For a diver's guide to underwater. For the clutter. There is a place that regularly floods. I first saw this place years ago when an acquaintance of mine, an artist, built an installation there. The work was very complicated. All of her artwork is. I remember it was made from huge piles of recycled newspapers. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to complete it before the flood came and wiped it out. The next time I passed by this place, it was full of young men and women on bicycles. They'd built a track weaving through the soggy ruins of my acquaintance's flooded artwork. The rising water level quickly made it too dangerous to ride in anymore, and many bicycles were crashed and abandoned. The last time I saw the place, it had been repurposed to store handmade pottery earmarked for sale out of state. By the time I arrived, there was just a pile of ceramic fragments dashed by floodwaters against rusting bicycles and gray pulp. I've heard recently that this place has been reclaimed again. Surely this time, things will be different. For a diver, people can't sleep in the wet grass or on the bridges of New Königsberg. They can't sleep anywhere near Lake Letha because it's too large. Nobody can sleep with their toes in the river because it's too cold. People can't sleep where I sleep because I'm all knees and elbows, and anyway, there isn't enough room for both of us. I'm not sure if anyone can sleep on the deck of the Mucky Mammoth, but I'm certain they can't sleep on the trash barge because of the smell. If you have anything to add, please call us back with extension 7360. For a diver's guide to underwater islands, press 1. For forgotten places, press 2. For restless places, press 3. For what little we know of the Iron Pariah, press 4. For food and drink recommendations, press 5. To return to the main menu, for food, press 1. For drink, press 2. To return to the main menu, if you plan your journey along the Echo to be a slow and thoughtful one, you will surely want to eat. It's true, and even advanced preparation can still fail you. Maybe the food you've packed will fall in the water and be spoiled, or it could be stolen by a bat. Well, the water sustains all travelers. Catch it yourself in the river, or have something prepared for you at this place out on the lake. The restaurant is called, it's out on Lake Letha. It has to be out there where the water is deepest. If you go early in the morning, you might see the diver bring in his nightly haul. Weird creatures from weird depths, fish, crabs, jellies, things we don't have proper names for at this elevation. Sam and Ida's, that's the name of it. Sam dives, Ida cooks. Unique fare and uncommon conversation, to say nothing of the decor. If you do stop by, tell them I said hello, and that they're always in my thoughts and prayers. For a diver's guide to underwater islands, press 1. For food, the water is fine, but more adventurous tourists will surely be looking for stronger stuff. Move quickly along past any strangers with cheap bourbon flasks. You can get that hard times rot gut anywhere. If you're traveling by boat, you'll want the traditional seafarer's liquor. As it happens, there's a watering hole called the Rum Colony, wholly devoted to the stuff. You know, mixed with sugar and bright colors. I've heard it's excellent, but I never drink the stuff. I take my spirits clear. For a diver's guide to underwater Welcome home. For historical sites along the Echo River, press 1. For a guide to the river's flora and fauna, press 2. For help identifying an unfamiliar sound, press 3. If you're holding a snake right now, press 4. To hear these options again, press. For different types of water, press 1. For the language of bats, press 2. For insect interactions, press 3. To return to the main menu, press 5. The Echo River is best known for its plentiful waters. Not their volume, but their diversity. There's surface water, deep water, big water, and small water. Water that moves quickly. Slower water. Water in a cup. There's the water you know about, the water you don't know about, and the water you only assume exists due to indirect evidence, like a rumbling sound behind the rock. Cool water, but also warm, and even warmer. Water that gets things clean. Water that only makes things dirtier. Water's both soft and hard. Water in living bodies. If you come across any other kind of water, be very careful. Call us back and dial extension 0464 just to be safe. For different types of water, press 1. For the language of bats, many find learning the language of bats to be intimidating, but it's really pretty straightforward. The most difficult part is getting your ultrasonic pronunciation right. See, bats have enormous, complex ears. For us, it's more of a struggle. Here, let's try some useful phrases. Repeat after me so you can practice your pronunciation. Here's how you say, "I don't know where I am." Okay, here's how you could ask, "Haven't we met before?" Great. And here's how you say, "Sorry, I must have left it in the boat." Now, a very useful phrase. "It's a shame we didn't record that." Every conversation has to end. So here's how to say, "I will write that down in case I forget it later." For different types of water, press 1. If you stop your boat somewhere cool, you may find yourself swarmed by insects. You may swat at them or cover your face, thinking they're all trying to bite you or buzz in your ear. But these insects are more interested in each other than they are in you. In fact, they've already forgotten you. They're back to chasing each other, breeding, competing over resources. Their minds are so shallow that while you've been standing there with your hands raised to your face, they've begun to think of you as part of the landscape, a funny-looking rock. This is what they sound like. Thank you.
The number you have dialed is not real.
Hello. You have dialed into Here and There Along the Echo, a guide to the Echo River for drifters and pilgrims. This guide is a public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. Resources, press 1. If you have an extension to dial, press 9. For more information about our organization, press 3. If you don't remember dialing this number at all, press 5. To hear these options again, press 0. The Bureau of Secret Tourism is supported by a generous population of river creatures whom I fix up and grill as necessary. I am environmentally minded, and I believe all creatures are equally deserving of support in their transition to the next world. So I usually try to sing a little elegy like, small water creature, crab or frog, now you know that sleep is all around us, like a muggy, tranquil fog. Something like that. It's easier to come up with these songs when I'm hungry in a sort of transcendental fasting state, but I've actually just had breakfast. A debt of gratitude is also owed to the Bureau of Reclaimed Spaces, who unselfishly and unknowingly donates this here telephone line for the purpose of this here informational resource. You can always find the latest secret tourism literature in any of our unmarked kiosks or any other old place it happens to lay. That's all I have to say about that. Hey, do me a favor. When you get a chance, call us back at extension 1928. You can press 0 now to go back to the main menu. Welcome home. For historical sites along the Echo River. Dialed into Here and There Along the Echo, a guide to the Echo River for drifters and pilgrims. This guide is a public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. Extension. Hello, stranger. What's the first thing you remember? When you're finished remembering, press the 0 button. Welcome home. For historical sites along the Echo. have dialed into Here and There Along the Echo, a guide to the Echo River for drifters and pilgrims. This guide is a public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. Extension. Something else shook loose. Well, how vivid is it? I mean, can you really smell it? Are you sweating it out now? Are your hands all damp, and when you brush your hair out of your eyes, it just tastes like... Listen, if your hands are damp, press 1. If your feet are damp in your socks, press 2. If you don't feel particularly damp anywhere, press 3. Oh, everyone has a damp spot somewhere in their body or mind. That's what lets us sort of squish a little when we try to remember something. Muddy the details, right? Even if it's just that wet blood sloshing around in there. Your soggy heart, right? Let's hear all about it. When you're finished explaining yourself, press the 0 button. Dialed into Here and There Along the Echo, a guide to the Echo River for drifters and pilgrims. This guide is a public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. Finished, press the 0 button. Well, dialed into Here and There Along the Echo, a guide to the Echo River for drifters and pilgrims. This guide is a public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. Now is the time to dial an extension. Found some weird water, huh? All right. We'd better catalog it. Hold the phone up to it for a bit, and we'll record it for later analysis. Press 0 when you're done. Welcome home. For historical sites along the Echo River, press... dialed into here and there along the Echo, a guide to the Echo River for drifters and pilgrims. This guide is a public service provided by the Bureau of Secret Tourism. Listen to the wind blow. Or even better, television static. Can you tune your TV to a dead station and let the static play into the phone? When you're finished, press the zero button. Thanks. Welcome home. Historical sites along the Echo River, press 1. For a guide to the river's flora and fauna,